This is daily flip number 56. Glad you're here today. Hope you had a great Memorial Day. I took it easy yesterday. I was gonna come in at work, but my wife and kids talked me into taking the day off, so I had a good time with them. Actually went to downtown Raleigh yesterday, checked out the Science and History Museum downtown Raleigh. So the kids loved it, had a good time there, except the AC was out in one of the buildings, so that was not good, so we went to the other building. But our AC is working. If you have been following along, we've had some AC troubles recently, so hopefully they don't follow us back here. We're nice and cool right now, except for outside, it's very hot. Actually, it's not that hot, it's just humid. In North Carolina, the humidity is just ridiculous. I've been drenched in sweat all day, not because I'm outside really hot, it's just the humidity kills. So I'm gonna run outside and show you what we've got going on. Today, we've been working on a few different things. This being one, being that you're probably watching on YouTube, maybe Facebook, YouTube is an excellent resource when you have an issue. Maybe you were interested in buying and selling cars for profit. You Googled how to buy and sell cars for profit. You somehow landed here. On this one, we had a starting issue. Actually, come around to the side over here. When I bought this at auction, this is what was written on the window. Push in on ignition switch when starting. It was even written on a piece of paper that was taped to the dash. Push in ignition when starting. This one wouldn't start unless you pushed in really hard, and even then it wouldn't always start. So I went on Google, which took me to YouTube, starting issues for, this is 2008. I found another guy that had a 2008, he was a mechanic, and he was saying, hey guys, Chevy is wanting to charge $1,500 to replace all these components. All you have to do is pull out the lock cylinder, pull the key out with the tumblers, don't disassemble it, just pull that out. You're gonna pull out the housing that goes in, put it in a clamp. We're gonna grind off about this much of a piece of metal on the ring. It's gonna allow the key to turn further. That's gonna allow your car to start every time with no problems. We did that, took out the Dremel, moved the metal, or took out the metal. It's perfect starting every time. That's the beauty of YouTube and the beauty of being able to get on the internet and figure out anything that you need to. So hopefully this channel can be that for you. For car flipping, or maybe tips and tricks on how to make extra money or extra cash doing that. So if you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, please do so, because I'm gonna be maybe not getting to this much depth mechanically, but the mindset about how to buy and sell cars. So if you haven't subscribed yet, I would love for you to be a subscriber so I can share more about flipping with you. But actually I have somebody right now, hopefully they don't pull in actually while we're doing this video. They're coming from about 20 minutes away. They told me that about 16 minutes ago. So we're gonna keep this timer going, so hopefully I don't be in a video when they come up. But the Navigator, we've had several people that have been fairly serious about it, or at least express interest. They have come and it's not worked out just yet. So this lady came, what's today? Today's Tuesday. I believe it was Thursday of last week. She came with her husband. Her husband was dead set against it. Actually, he was, I don't want to say rude, but he didn't want to be here. He didn't want to be car shopping. She like thought she had found the one, and he was like, we're not buying this car, like old grumpy man. You know, the guy like when you walk on the grass, he's like, get off my lawn. He was like that guy, except he was here, and he was like, I'm not buying this car. So hopefully she comes without him today, and maybe we can get something done. She loved it. She loved the heated, cooled seats, the DVD, the power lift gate. When you open the doors, it's got the steps that slide out. She was just amazed. So hopefully she can come today without him and we can work something out. But I stand on this one. I think if the price that we've agreed upon she buys it for, we've got the $2,000 profit set on that one. So hopefully that works out. Otherwise, coming around here, this is actually a vehicle we're doing some service work on. We do that from time to time. We don't advertise it, but we've got a pretty good reputation on the mechanic side. So they had a water pump they believed to have gone bad. Their belt snapped. Might not be that. It could just be that a pulley snapped, which then caused it to overheat because the water pump's not spinning. But either way, belt snapped. Something's locked up. That's keeping that from functioning. As you can see, I've had my pressure washer out today. We have a vehicle in the back. I think I mentioned last week, a 2007 Chrysler Pacifica. It's disgusting. Like, it was coming to the auction, it was rainy. I didn't look in it good enough, and it just is horrendously dirty. This seat here, actually, I'm gonna attempt to fix this. If I can pull off this cloth, which shouldn't be that difficult, I'll be able to sew this from the inside, and then I can put it back on. Worst case, I'll sew it from out here and it won't look the best, but it'll be okay. If I can just get this off, there's a few little pieces that flip up from the back. If I can just pull this off, I'll flip this together, sew it myself, and call that a day. If you could have seen this before, and actually I might be able to show you in the back what this looked like before. I can show you some other seats. This was just disgusting. It was brown, so I soaked it with Purple Power, brought out the pressure washer, let this soak in for 5-10 minutes, didn't want it to dry, and we're letting it dry now. So it actually seems to have come out pretty good. We'll see once it dries what it looks like. I gotta bring this in a minute, but I've been putting it off because it's so nasty humid out here. Moving around the back tomorrow, this is a project we'll be working on. Actually, over here we've got a tail light to go on. Here we've got a one that's broken here. It's like 30 bucks on eBay, if I'm not mistaken. We had some body work done on this, so all we have left is our pieces of molding, which we have. We've got some Quickset 20 to adhere this back. I don't have these exact clips, but the Quickset 20 is going to glue it up there. It'll never come off again. We'll be doing the same with our steps. This is not what it's supposed to look like. There's a piece of plastic that goes over this. We've got those. This metal here is most likely going to have to be bent out a little bit, which shouldn't be that difficult. It's not that thick, really. I'm not going to move with my hand a little bit. I have to pull this out a little bit so that we can put the plastic back on and it doesn't rub. You can see right here, this has been hitting a little right here as it's been opening and closing. This is, once the door opens, this touches a little bit. So we're going to pull this forward, adhere the other piece of plastic right here. You can tell somebody's tried to put some double-sided tape to hold on the plastic before. That didn't do so well. We'll either try to clip, and we may even try to clip the one over there, but our Quickset 20 will hold this no problem. It'll never come off again. Otherwise, this one's done. Coming through the back here, we have a strut coming in for this one. Should arrive today, hopefully. Maybe tomorrow. We have a front driver's side strut that I actually got for like $22 on an Amazon warehouse deal. That's an insanely good deal for a strut. It's a complete strut assembly, has everything included. You just pull the old one, put this one in, has a spring and everything, so you can't beat that. This one here, our timing kit is in. We're gonna need to hopefully install that. If we can do it this week, that'd be amazing. I'm having a feeling it's gonna be the beginning of next. Gotta have some body work done. Otherwise, we're good to go on this one. This is our Pacifica in the back. I'll show you the disgusting interior. Hopefully, if the door's unlocked, hopefully we're still good on time. I haven't seen anybody pull in as of yet. So, yeah, here we go. So this is actually a very clean seat compared to the one that I pulled out. My detail guy Saturday had scrubbed the best that he could and steam cleaned this. We still have some stains that are remaining. If you just look at the carpet though, and if you look at the carpet over there where the seat was, first you're gonna think, Justin, what were you thinking? Why did you buy this car? I'm halfway thinking the same thing, but once we get these seats cleaned up, I think we'll be in good shape. If you bring it up front here, this one might show you, this one isn't even as dirty as the one that I cleaned, but that front seat there might show you a little more, just the stains. I mean, it's just bad. So the carpet on this one, we're probably gonna end up pulling every single one of these seats. On the Pacifica, actually, to remove the front seats, you have to put it up on a lift, or you could crawl under it if you want to, but I would prefer not to. We're gonna put it on the lift. We're gonna unbolt the seats because they actually bolt up on the bottom over here. There's bolts that shoot down. There's nuts on the bottom. You have to remove those from underneath. So we'll pull these seats out. We'll pull these seats. There's just two bolts on these rear seats. These are really easy. And then in the back, we'll pull the rear seats. We'll pull everything out. We're gonna soak it with Purple Power. We're going to then let it dry. Then while that's out, we're gonna be steam cleaning the interior. I'm halfway convinced I'm gonna pull the carpet and steam pressure wash that as well. May just end up steam cleaning it, letting it dry and dyeing it. So I'm back and forth on what I'm gonna do there. Otherwise, I need a piece of molding. Some things you don't see until after you buy the car. I don't know how I missed that being gone. It was a rainy day. A rainy day is never a good day to buy a car because things look a lot better than they do when you actually see them when they're dry. So great time to sell a car, not the best to buy, but this one, it's gonna work out. We just gotta get some of the detailing finished up. Motor mounts go in maybe tomorrow, should be this week. We have a front motor mount, which are very common. It was so bad, it actually caused the side one to go bad, and we have an oxygen sensor. Then that one's good mechanically. Coming inside, I think that really is about everything. We've got a 2005 Audi A4 in here. It just needs a blower motor, and then we are good to go there. Otherwise, a little bit of body work, the back of the door. I'm standing right where I am right now because my fan is blowing on me and it feels wonderful now that we're in the shade. So that's it for today. If you have any questions about anything you saw today, let me know. Otherwise, today is Tuesday. I believe it's May the 29th. On June the 1st, which comes up this Friday at midnight, the car flip course closes. So right now the car flip course is open. It's available. You can register. Come Friday, it closes. You will not be able to get in until we open it up later this year. So if you are considering joining, don't put it off, because if you're anything like me, you'll forget. You'll wake up Saturday morning and think, ah, why didn't I join? So I would love to see you on the inside. Basically, it's everything that I have up here. I put it into a video format. And then there's also a community aspect. If you're a member of the CarFit Facebook group, if you're not, you should be. Go to facebook.com/group/thecarflip. Hopefully that's correct. That'll take you there. You can join that. That's absolutely free. You'll see that there's about 3,000 people in that group. I can't keep up with 3,000 people. It's just not possible. So if you have a question, I might see it. I might not. Inside the course community, if you post a question, I'm going to see it. I'm going to answer it every single time. There's also an individual, not individual, there's a group coaching. So every single month, there is a day set aside where we have a video call where you can ask me any questions you want to. You can interact with other people in the group. And there are something we call templates. We just recorded a few today, which are basically cars that I'm flipping, giving you exactly what I paid, what I had to fix. So basically my projected profit based off of those numbers, which then allows you to take those vehicles and look for them in your area. And if you can match up the numbers, you know there's profit to be made. But if you are at all considering joining that, check out thecarflipcourse.com. It is, as far as I know, the premier car flipping course that I have seen. And there's the course, you know, the content, but I think the most valuable part is the interaction with the people inside the course, as well as direct access to me from the community and in the live monthly call. So I would love to see you on the inside. Otherwise, I will see you in tomorrow's Daily Flip.